Death is not opposite to life, but it is part of life. But we don't know what happens after our death. We don't know when will death occur to us. But Jesus Christ gives us a ray of hope. Jesus Christ gives us a ray of hope, confidence and consolation that all people who have died before us will be raised up by Jesus at the last day. Jesus was raised up by the Father. Similarly, the faithful departed in our family will be raised up by Jesus at one day. St. Paul says, "For to me to live is Christ, to die is gain. For to me to live is Christ, to die is gain." Philippians chapter 1 verse 21. That's why the beauty of the Christian death is that through our baptism we have already died with Christ in order to have new life. That's why, my dear faithful, death is like a tragedy. Death is like a tragedy. It is because when a person is born in this world, all those people who are surrounding him, the parents, the relatives of the person, they are very joyful and rejoicing over his birth in this world. But only the person cries when he is born in this world. But similarly, when the same person dies in this world, all people who are surrounding him, they were sad, they were mourning. But the person is joyful. The person is rejoicing because he goes to the Lord. He goes to heaven. That's why at times we will have experienced the pain of the death of our beloved at a certain point of time in our lives. Yes, dear faithful, death is painful, but it is also a joyful thing. Death is painful, it is also a joyful thing because of the invitation of hope, because of the confidence in Jesus Christ, our Savior, the resurrected Christ. That's why when we participate in the Holy Mass, especially in the funeral Mass, the priest says in the face this way, in him the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of death might be consoled. O Lord, indeed you are faithful. Life is changed but not ended. When this earthly dwelling turned to the dust, our eternal dwelling is made ready for you in the heaven. That's why we are faithful. For a believer, when you live in Christ, death is a passage from the earthly pilgrimage to the heavenly homeland, where the Father establishes the interconnectedness with all his children. That's why, for a believer, when you live in Christ, death is a passage from the earthly pilgrimage to the heavenly homeland, where the Almighty God establishes the interconnectedness with all his children. That's why our Savior Jesus Christ effectively says in John's Gospel, chapter 11, verse 25, "I am the resurrection and life. Our God will never abandon us because he is the life giver of our existence." As we hope for the resurrection, by your faith, we are supposed to do a PhD in this world. You might be surprised. What is that PhD? We do PhD in this world by our profession. We do PhD in our world by our studies. But as a Christian, by the virtue of baptism, you and I are supposed to do a PhD. Do you know that PhD? P means preparation for, H means happy, D means death. Preparation for happy death. When we live this world, we have to prepare for our death as we hope for the resurrection in our Savior. That's why at the juncture, we must remember that no power, no weakness of the faithful departed can prevent from their resurrection, because they believed in Jesus Christ, they believed in the resurrection of the body. In the light of resurrection, we are all saved according to the will of God. Jesus died and rose from the dead with the same resurrection. the risen Lord will share the mercy of resurrection with all. So let us pray in this holy Eucharistic celebration that God may share the resurrection of mercy with all the faithful departed. Let us also ask our blessed Virgin Mary, who always prays for us, especially at the hour of our death, through her powerful intercession, we all may be received into eternal life, that the fragrance of resurrection of Jesus may reach to the people who are at the fringes of the church and to the people who are least and the lost. That the fragrance of resurrection of Jesus may reach to the people who are at the fringes of the church and to the people who are